of 239.
Very briefly, I was pleased to see this, whatever form it takes, because one of the things as we finish off this bill that's consistently come up is where those of us who have raised problems, potentially of unintended consequences, whether age gating is going to lead to a huge invasion of privacy of adults rather than just narrowly protecting children, whether the powers given to Ofcom turning it into the most important and powerful regulator in the country, if not in Europe, in a highly complex bill, whether it is possible for us to keep our eye on it a bit more than just whinging on the sidelines. I think the noble Baroness Stowell makes a very important point about the issue in relation to the FCA and banking, because nobody intended that to be the outcome, for example, of PEPs. Nobody intended that when they suggested that banks might have values, ESG, EDI, nobody's thinking, oh, equality, diversity and inclusion values for banks. Let's encourage that. Nobody thought that was going to lead to ordinary citizens of this country threatened with having their banking turned off. And it's too late to then retrospectively say, oh, that wasn't what we ever intended. So, quite straightforwardly, from the point of view of scrutiny, I do hope that we don't let this Ofcom go off and say, arm's length regulators, we'll leave it up to them, we're not going to look at it again. My consistent concerns about free speech being threatened by this bill, you can come back and say to me, oh, you were wrong, Baroness Fox, but you can only say that if we've got a very clear view that Ofcom are not behaving in a way that's going to damage the freedom of expression rights of people in this country.
I'd rise briefly to associate myself with the comments of my noble friend, Baroness Stowell, on the...